Now I'm going to take you through using Tinkercad to create your first design.
We're going to use tinkercad.com to create our very first design. Click on Sign in the top right-hand corner. You're going to select Sign in with Google, and we're going to use our Department of Education Google credentials. Simply type in your email address. That's just adding @education.nsw.gov.au to the end of your username. Click Next. Now you just need to enter in your credentials as normal. If Tinkercad is loading for the first time, you'll see a welcome tutorial. Feel free to close it by clicking the X in the top right hand corner. To start making our very first design, we're going to click on Create New Design. When Tinkercad loads up, you will see the workspace that we are going to be using. You can make adjustments to this workspace, but you can look at the instructions on how to do that in a different video. I'm just going to close this pop-up on the side. And the very first thing I'm going to do is name my design. Tinkercad auto-saves as design as we're working, but it often comes up with these quite unusual names. So I'm going to give it a name. To help me with designing my first design, and we're going to be making a keyring. To do this, I'm going to use the shapes that are on the right hand side, and there is a whole selection of different shapes that I can choose. For this particular item, it's best to choose a shape that has a flat top and a flat bottom, and this will just help us with the printing process. So feel free to choose anything that has a flat top and a flat bottom. And you just click and drag it onto your work plane. Using the handles, I can adjust the size and dimensions of my shape. So I've dragged it out. The other thing I can do is adjust the height. So I'm going to flatten it out to about 5 millimeters. And I can check my design from a couple of different angles. This is really important to do. Okay, so I'm pretty happy with my design here. Now, because this is my keyring, I'm going to go down and I'm going to find the text and drag that and place it on top of my shape. And because my name is not text, I need to change the writing that is in this field here. Putting in my name, and using the handles, I can adjust I can click and drag and place the name wherever I'm happy. Now, with the name here, if I was to hang this letter off the side, it might fall off once the printing's completed because it's not attached. Now, it's a really handy idea to make sure whilst you're designing that you are checking your design from a couple of different angles, because sometimes things like this can happen where from the top everything looks good, but you can actually see from a different perspective that there is actually a big gap between these two items. So I'm just using the triangle icon at the top, and this moves the item sort of up and down. So I'm just making sure I'm embedding that text into the shape on the bottom. So now I'm just going to adjust the height. So it just needs to be just a little bit higher than the base shape. So we're just going to make a few adjustments now until I'm happy with my sort of finished layout here. So now I have the text and I have the base, and I just need to add a hole over here. We have these gray shapes, and these gray shapes are sort of hollow versions, if you like. So if I position that, and again, I'm going to resize as required, and rotate, and then using the triangle icon at the top. I'm going to sort of punch it through. And what I mean by that is action is a bit like a hole punch in this case. I want it to go through all those layers to make sure that that hole is cutting all the way through. And I may just need to make some adjustments about where I need to locate this. So just making those adjustments as required. Oops, I shrunk it. When I'm happy with the layouts and just double checking, I like to really make sure that I can see that hollow shape coming all the way through. My next step is to group the design. To do that, I'm going to click and drag and sort of capture everything inside this red box. And now I'm going to group the shapes by selecting this icon up in the top ribbon. You can see it's made some changes. I can see straight through where that cylinder is. And now when I rotate, everything is as if it is one. This is a really good step for checking your design one final time before you export it. So export is in the top right hand side. And we're going to export this design as an .stl file. This is the file that the slicing software for the 3D printer can read. And that's creating your very first design using Tinkercad.
This video is part of a series of support videos all about the kit that you have borrowed. To find the other videos in this series, head to the Learning Library and visit the kit page for the equipment you've borrowed. You can also find the full list of support videos for all of our kit on the YouTube channel. You can also join us in the Yammer community. If you have any questions or you'd like to ask teachers how they've used the equipment in their classroom, then why not join us on the STEM T4L Facebook community? It's a closed group. You can ask teachers how they've used the equipment and also share the work samples that your students have created.